This video is an introduction to active filters. It corresponds to section 24.1 of the Applied Analog Electronics textbook. Now, there are a lot of differences between active filters and passive filters. The passive filters are the simple RC filters that we looked at before, which just had resistors and capacitors in them. Passive filters are very cheap because they just have resistors and capacitors, no amplifiers. There are no gain bandwidth limitations because there are no amplifiers. And there's no power supply needed for passive filters because there's no amplifiers. But the main limitations of passive filters are because there's no amplifiers, the gain is always one or less, and it's difficult sometimes to decompose the design because the passive ones don't provide any isolation between the input and the output. Everything is connected together. Active filters allow us to separate our design into modules that each one of which we can treat independently. It allows us to cascade multiple filters together without the filters interfering with each other. It allows us to have gains that are larger than one or less than negative one if we're doing an inverting amplifier. And it turns out that also some of the math is simpler for the active filters than for the passive filters. So let's take a look at what we've got. All right. The simple passive filters, as you remember, were just an input, an impedance, another impedance, and a connection to, I'll say ground, but it was usually some reference voltage. Doesn't necessarily have to be 0 volts. And then that goes to the output. And the gain of this filter is the ZF over ZF plus ZI. If we look at what does the impedance look like from the input, assuming that we're not taking any current from the output, it's so ZN is just ZI plus ZF. If there's a load out here, that changes everything. Changes not only the behavior of the circuit, what the gain is, but it also changes the input impedance. The output impedance of this, because it's a voltage divider, is ZI in parallel with ZF. So that if you are trying to drive a load out here, you've got possibly a substantial impedance, which can cause you problems unless the thing out here really doesn't take any current. Okay, so passive was relatively simple, but only if you had a fair amount of current available at the input and didn't take any current from the output. All right, there are two different amplifier designs we've had, inverting and non-inverting, and they both look much the same, in that we have got two impedances, and I'll call this one ZI and this one ZF. And I'm going to draw what looks like exactly the same circuit here. The difference between these two circuits is that in one case, I put VREF on the positive input and the input on the negative one. And in the other case, I put VREF on the negative input and VIN on the positive one. What is the gain of each of these? Well, these are just the standard negative feedback amplifiers. So this one has a gain of minus ZF over ZI. The input impedance is just ZI, and the output impedance is approximately zero. For this one, the gain is 1 plus ZF over ZI. ZN is approximately infinity, And Z out is again approximately 0 ohms. So, which of these do we use? Well, it depends. It depends on what sort of filter characteristics you want to get. Quite often when we're using a filter, we want to completely eliminate some signal. For instance, we may be doing a high-pass filter that completely eliminates a DC bias. Well, if you're trying to completely eliminate something, 1 plus is not going to do it. So we generally do not use the non-inverting configuration if we're really trying to zero something out. So if we're trying to do a DC blocking, we don't use a non-inverting amplifier. If you're just trying to reduce something, though, I mean, you can do something where the gain is 1 or close to 1 at a particular frequency, but then at the frequencies you're interested in, you have a much larger gain. That may sometimes be useful. And so we do sometimes use this non-inverting amplifier because it's got a very high input impedance, which is handy. It means we don't need any current from the input. And they both have very low output impedances, essentially zero if these were perfect op amps. The design for the gain is easier if we have this ZF minus ZF over ZI, because then we can get zeros just by making a zero for ZF at the frequency that we want to get a zero. So for instance, if we want to do DC blocking, we can make ZI be infinite at DC. So putting a capacitor somehow as part of ZI will make this thing be DC blocking. So the more common filter design is this inverting one, because it's easier to design. We don't have this 1 plus on the gain to worry about. We can get zeros, and we can get fairly large gains also. The big advantages of the active filter over the passive one: zero output impedance. Okay, so that we can drive things with this, and it doesn't really affect anything. You know, this thing can provide a fair amount of current. Fairly easily defined input impedances. The infinite input impedance of the non-inverting filter is particularly nice, but at the cost of not being able to get zero on the gain. Here, the input impedance is just what you put on ZI, so that's fairly easy to control also. And unlike the passive filter, where all these things were based on the assumption of no load, so that was a strong assumption here. We didn't put anything there. Here, we can put a load on this, and it's not going to affect the filter as long as the op amp is capable of delivering the current that the load needs. Here, you put anything after this, changes the filter. And that makes designing passive filters much trickier. Also, this function, ZF over ZF plus ZI, is a messier function than the minus ZF over ZI. So it's easier often to design an active filter than a passive one. Now, this is not the only design for an active filter, incidentally. This is simply the simplest one that uses just the negative feedback amplifier designs that we've had so far. It is possible to do things where you get multiple feedback paths. And with the multiple feedback paths, you can actually get more complicated filters that have not just, this is essentially, we can get two first order parts to this. So we can do a bandpass filter. You can get something with more higher order filters out of a single op amp if you use multiple feedback paths. There's some discussion of that in the book. But it's an optional section. We don't need it for anything we do in this course. So all the things we do in this course, you can use one of these two active filters or the passive filter. Incidentally, there's something that's kind of a compromise between the passive filter and the active filter. And that is, we can do a passive filter. And here I will put VREF rather than zero, and we could take this thing then into a filter, not a filter, but a negative feedback op amp that's just a non-inverting amplifier. So this is RF and RI. And now we don't have any load on this passive filter because it's going into something that doesn't take any current. And so we do indeed get the passive properties in terms of the gain, except for our gain is now multiplied by, so we have the ZF over ZF plus ZI times 1 plus RF over RI as the gain. And Zin is the same as before. And Z out from this whole thing is now approximately 0 ohms. So this is technically a passive filter followed by an amplifier, but it has some of the nice characteristics of the active filter in that it can have a gain bigger than 1. It can have 0 output impedance so that it can drive current into a load without changing the characteristics of the filter at all. And it's got an input impedance that's ZI plus ZF, which is a little bit different than the one where we have the non-inverting amplifier by itself. So generally, if you need to have something that's easily specified as a passive filter, but you need more gain from it, you can do a passive filter followed by the non-inverting amplifier. Okay, I think that's probably enough on generalities. In subsequent videos, we'll look at specific designs to do low pass, high pass, and band pass filters.